Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Recently I've received several emails asking me why my Photoshop software looks different. It seems quite a few people are confused by my layout because it's not standard. In this video, I'm going to explain why my copy of Photoshop probably looks different to yours. I'll also explain what you can do to change yours if you want to. Let's start by looking at the interface I use. You can see that I only have six windows visible. That's the histogram, navigator, properties, adjustments, layers, and channels. That's because these are the windows that I use all the time for my photo editing. In Photoshop, we call this layout of the windows the workspace. Let's switch now to the default layout for Photoshop. We can do this using the Windows menu. In there, you'll find the Workspaces option and the Essentials Default, which is the default for Photoshop. As you can see, that now looks quite different to how I had it before. There's also other workspaces you can choose from, including a photography workspace. And there's a painting workspace which looks very different yet again. When you're working with Photoshop, it's easy to become accustomed to using a particular layout, but it's also very easy to change the layout, sometimes by accident and sometimes you don't even realise it's changed. For example, I've had software that I've installed that's also changed my layout. Let's look at an example. I'll remove the brushes window from the docking panel so that it becomes free-floating. I can even dock the window on the other side of the interface. A lot of new Photoshop users drag and change the layout of these windows by accident and then don't know how to reset them. Even changing to another workspace doesn't fix it. The only way to return the workspace to the way it looked before is to reset it in the window menu. Because of the flexibility in Photoshop, it's a good idea to create your own custom workspace. We can start with the Essentials default workspace. I'm then going to remove any of the windows that I don't need. I can then add any missing windows that I use regularly. When I have the interface looking the way I want it, I can save it using the window menu. When I use the new workspace option, I can enter the name of my new workspace. You can also see in the dialog that I have the options to include keyboard shortcuts, menus, and toolbars in this workspace. That's because you can configure all of these things in Photoshop and save them as part of the workspace. Now I can see the demo workspace I've just created in the Workspaces menu. This means that if I change something in error, I can now reset it using the option. If I want to delete the workspace, all I need to do is change to a different workspace. I can then pick the Delete Workspaces option from the window menu. Then select the workspace to delete from the drop-down menu. So next time you find yourself confused because Photoshop doesn't look the way you want it to, start by resetting the workspace. If you share your computer with another Photoshop user, it's best to save your own custom workspace. If you'd like to know more about using Photoshop and configuring the interface, I've covered all this in my book, Essential Adobe Photoshop CC. I'll include details of where to find it in the video information below. I hope you found today's video helpful. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you soon for another video.